Tessa Ray Yoga. Hello! Today we are going to be working on a pose called Crow. It is an awesome, empowering arm balance. This pose is close to my heart because it was like the challenging pose that I had as a beginner, and I practiced over and over and over again, and then I got it, and it just made me feel like so confident and so just like strong and ready to do more yoga, really. So I'm gonna teach you how to approach it in a safe and effective way. So we're gonna start in tabletop position, toes tucked. We're gonna warm up our wrists. We're gonna press into the base of our fingers, and we're gonna lift our palms up and down. And if that's too much pressure on the hands right away, just take your hands a little closer to your knees and just practice that. So this is like finger flexibility as well as creating some strength in the hands, which is important. Something to keep in mind when we're practicing Crow is that we want to practice it over and over again and build up our endurance and our strength, but we also need to just honor where our wrists are at and not force them into pain. We're gonna come on to our fists now. So fists, they're facing in towards one another, and I've brought them a little bit narrower, so you can have them close to the knees, which is probably what I recommend, but if you're quite strong here, you can be in tabletop. When you open onto the back of the fist, try to line up your wrist with your shoulder, and then back to the top of the fist, and I'm gonna do one at a time just to find my alignment, so the wrist lines up with the shoulder, and then I might switch to both hands. Some variations are you can open the hands, which is less intense. And again, the closer the hands are to your knees, the less intense on the wrists it's going to be. Okay, keeping the fist closed, a little more intense. And starting to work your core here. So lifting your belly button towards your lower back and up underneath your rib cage. Now we're going to flip the fingers back and just work our wrist flexibility in this way. People might find that your elbows kind of like pop forward. So be mindful of hypermobile elbows here. Little micro bend for you, and then press into all 10 fingertips and really get used to finding the strength in the hands and the strength in the fingers. That's going to get us to take the pressure off of our wrists. And then I'm going to keep the base of my fingers down and peel the palms away and peel the fingers away. So coming back to tabletop and coming into your cat-cow, let's exhale to curl and inhale to arch, and just do that a couple more times. Exhale round, inhale arch. As I'm rounding, I'm pulling my belly in and I'm pushing the floor away with my hands. Okay, and then let's come to just a straight spine, what we think a straight spine is. Lift the belly up, and then we're gonna sink into the shoulders and broaden between the shoulder blades. So just moving the scapula towards the spine and then away from the spine. Keep a neutral, kind of relaxed neck, maybe gently rooting back into the skull. Sink and push, go at your own pace. This one can be a bit confusing when you first learn it, but once you figure it out, it feels amazing. Okay, now we're gonna round our back like angry kitty back. Round, push the floor away. Lift your toes towards your bum. Squeeze your bum, lift your belly up, push the floor away, and then look between your hands. Relax that, bring your toes down, push your fingertips into the floor, lift your knees up. Bring your knees down, let's draw our right knee in towards our forehead. Push the floor away, broaden between the shoulder blades. Draw the belly up. Take your right knee down and swap. Left knee to forehead. Push the floor away. Try to balance the weight in both hands and pull the left toes towards your bum. Draw your belly and your ribs up away from the floor. Everything coming down. We're going to come onto our forearms now, and this is where I want you to get a connection with your elbows. So line your outer elbow up with your outer shoulder. So you're making like a straight line from outer wrist to outer elbow to outer shoulder. In other words, don't let the elbows go wider than the shoulders or the hands. Glue your elbows into the floor, push the floor away, tuck your toes, lift your belly to your low back, even allowing the lower back to curve a little bit, and hover the knees. Try to keep your shoulders stacking over your elbows. Push into your fingertips, look forward. And let your knees come down. And then we're gonna let our feet go a little wide. We're gonna come over our feet into Malasana or squat. And then just kind of like playing here a little bit. So letting the hips warm up, you can walk the hands forward and stretch out your back a little bit. Letting the head dangle, just giving yourself a moment of like passive stretching. So what we've done is kind of activated our core and got our arms and hands ready for a couple minutes of play. So in your squat, and you don't have to have your heels down, by the way, you're just kind of like balancing at this point. You're gonna take your hands about a shoulder's width, lift your hips, and you're gonna create kind of like crab cracker legs. Your arms are the crab leg and your legs are the crab cracker. And you're going to squeeze your legs into your upper arms. And then the way to balance is the scary part. You're gonna stack your elbows over your wrists and let your shoulders come forward. And you wanna look forward and just play with picking up one foot. Let that foot come down. Play with the other foot picking up. So do that until you feel like literally your feet are gonna float naturally. I encourage you not to jump. Press into your fingertips. Squeeze your elbows in line with your wrists. Looking forward. And then just like take a break. Take a break from trying. Let go of any expectations. That's a big thing. Like seriously, who cares if you like get the pose? And just like ground yourself. Find your breath. Think about the core connections that we're working here, belly lifting to back, maybe giving your wrists a little stretch. So squeezing fists and drawing them in can be nice. Child's pose is a great option. And then you just want to keep playing with it, releasing your wrists as often as you need. I'll talk you through it again. So hands a shoulder's width, lift your hips. Now people who are hypermobile like me, like you can really lift your hips and you can try to get your elbows like in at your armpits, which is not what I recommend for a beginner. So if that resonates with you, just try your hips a bit lower and your legs are kind of, it's like shin on upper arm. You're gonna squeeze your shins into your upper arms. You're gonna lean your weight forward, shoulders forward, gazing forward. I always say if you look down, you're going down. So look forward. Squeeze your thighs into your arms. Point your toes and lift your toes towards your bum. Lift your belly to your low back. Keep squeezing with your legs. Breathing. Pressing into all 10 fingertips. And coming out. Just keep practicing. Keep working your endurance and the length of hold. And yeah, good luck and have fun.